Hey everyone, how's it going? It's Najam back again with another video. Now today I've actually got a quite a cool product. It's to do with the microphone setup. Now previously we did look at this on my channel, and now this is a tabletop tripod which you can put your camera on, or you can put anything that a tripod takes, a DSLR for example. Maybe a cinema camera if you're stupid enough to put it on this thing. Now this thing, I really like it because it works out really good. But what if you wanted a microphone on the table? Because I've got a massive microphone boom. I'm gonna show you that right now. Okay, so this is my microphone boom that I use, and it's really long, as you can see, and it's quite annoying and it takes up a lot of space. So I wanted to use up less space, and so I got something that's a little smaller, much smaller actually. And this is the cheap tabletop microphone stand that you can see on eBay on the top of the page for just £3. So let's take a closer look at this thing and I'll show you what you can do with it. I can sort of rig you up. I can also put pop filter on, but it won't stick to this thing for me. That is, this thing is too thin. And first I was a little depressed, but then I got over it and I figured out how it works. So yeah, let's take a closer look into this thing. Okay, sorry about that, I had to switch the camera because that one, other one's low on battery now apparently. Anyways, so this is the really cheap microphone boom, and I know it's a little bleached out, my phone is really bad at this video. Now it just comes like this in the package, and I was like, okay, so this is really small, and it's really too small, I would say, because for the size, I mean, you know, considering the size of any microphones out there, I thought this was way too small. So as you can see, it's quite small, and you can actually fit this in your pocket apparently, and that's what I like about it. It's just really small. Now when I first got it out, I thought this is not going to work with pretty much anything of mine that I've got, because I've got a massive thing that I need to put on top of it, and that's a zoom recorder, this one here. And this thing is really heavy with two AA batteries in it, you know, and I was a little skeptical about this when I got this. So but then it sort of fell in, and I figured out con, you know, a way to use it. So what you basically do is pop out the legs, like triangle, you know, don't do that. And the legs are actually quite nice. They have a soft foam feet, no rubber, but they're just soft foam. Now the first thing I realized was that this does not hold. So you can see it just doesn't hold, it just slips off. So I was like, no microphone is gonna work with this thing. This thing is way too stupid. And then obviously you can sort of tighten it, but then here's the problem. So you basically just pull this down, and there's this thing over here that sort of keeps it from slipping off, and that, and you basically tighten it as much as you can and keep tightening it. Apparently this is a mic boom, and unlike a tripod, it's got a whole lot of mechanisms. And then it does slide down, but if you push it, it does. So I don't know. Now we can't use a pop filter with this because this is too slim. Now there's a workaway, you know, I work around on that because I did figure one out. Now to stick your normal microphones on, you're gonna need one of these. Now these are your typical microphone boom, the stand kind of thing, the holders. And now this is not the one that came with this. No, the one that came with this is in my chest. I don't really want to use it because it's one of those typical handheld microphone holders, you know, the one that singers use. So whatever, I mean, this is a, I think it's a 5/8 hole screw, I don't know. Okay, don't hate me on this, I just don't know my screws. And it just pops onto this. And one thing I don't really find really funny about this is when it's on, you need to screw it completely down for the best, obviously. And that's what I'm gonna do right now. Now I know there's a background noise, so sorry about that. But once it's completely screwed on, as you can see, that's a shock mount for shotgun microphones. You won't be able to twist it around, okay? You can't turn with it. You have to turn the whole tripod. So it's another funny thing. But Then what you need to do is place a microphone on. Now with any microphone it should work perfectly fine, because they're just going to be coming straightforward, and they should be like microphones, the XLR microphones that I'm talking about. But microphones like this have a really hard time with this thing. This camera is really really bad, isn't it? Because this thing is heavy, and if I place this down, because I need it to be up like this, because this microphone is at the back. Now in the future, yes, I will get a shotgun microphone for this, but for now we're gonna have to use this because this is the only thing I have. Now you just place this in and it does work, it just holds your microphones in, but the thing is, it's not really steady. It wants to fall sideways, that way. But that leg is over there, and if you were to hold it this way around, there's no leg over here. It would completely want to, fall over. So I've got it on that side, so that works okay. But then again, it's no good, right? Because I don't know. It's not gonna hold something heavy like this. But it was fine. Now I figured out a way to sort of counterbalance it, and that's using a pop filter. Now one thing is, I do really want to use a pop filter with this, so it's okay with me. But if you don't want to use a pop filter, then I don't know. Now let me go get my pop filter. Okay, I know this cable is doing funny business because I've got it plugged into my Zoom recorder. It's the only Zoom recorder I have, so yeah, calm yourself down. That's the microphone I'm using to record, and this is the pop filter. You see? Well, I'm just going to show you the holder then, because it's too big. Look, it doesn't go around this. If you plug it in, I mean, if you just tighten it down. And I'm guessing this is the only pop filter that does this. It's a really cheap one, that's why. It is dual layer though, so you have to give them that. It won't hold, okay? I mean, it's gonna stay there, but it can spin freely. It's not tight enough to sort of keep it, getting off. But then, after a couple of while, I was getting a little pissed, but then that came into my head. That is the screw that sort of keeps it from slipping around, but you can just plug this on top and it should work fine with that. And apparently for me it does, it works fine on this. So I'm just gonna screw this on here and screw it really really tight, so it's not gonna move. And then guess what? So this is what we have next, and this is the setup that I will be using for my future videos on recording my audio. And you can see it's really really nice. It's really small as well, actually. If you really think about it, it's actually quite small as opposed to my other boom, which just fills up the whole table, so this is it's okay. I mean, it's perfectly balanced because the pop filter is really really heavy as well, so you have to sort of give them for that. And yeah, so my Zoom recorder is on top, and this actually I do like it. It's a little, really cheap and everything. And one thing I don't like about it is that the screw that sort of pushes it up and down, but the rest is just fine. I really like it. It actually works out with me and stuff. Now in the future I will be using this to record my over voiceovers, but I'm sort of gonna leave that later on in the future, and I'm gonna go on sort of live, but I'm gonna script them a little bit and stuff, so it makes it a little better, like MKBHD and stuff. So it's gonna be like that. But anyways, this is it for now. I'm switching from my massive boom, which used to be over there on the side, and I'm just going to this. So yeah, so it's pretty cool. I know it's not the best quality. This camera is really really bad. It just bleaches everything up, but I'm really sorry about this. I will get a proper camera in the future. But for now, I'm really sorry. Anyways, so that's it for this video. Thank you guys for watching. If you did enjoy, which you probably didn't because of the camera quality, well, either way, just hit that like button, and thanks for watching. I will see you again in a different video.